Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. I am Dr. Perkins, a board certified OBGYN, and we talk about important topics about your body right here on this channel. And today, we're talking about bacterial vaginosis and can you give bacterial vaginosis to a man? So let's dive into our topic today. By the end of this video, you will know, can you give your male partner bacterial vaginosis, also known as BV, symptoms of bacterial vaginosis in men. Uncircumcised men have bacterial vaginosis, and how to protect yourself from BV if you are male or female. So let's talk about it. Bacterial vaginosis is an infection of the vagina. And I want to really start by prefacing this now, because when we think of having a male with bacterial vaginosis, they don't have a vagina. So no, they're not going to have bacterial vaginosis. However, males can absolutely carry the bacteria that is most common in bacterial vaginosis. So before we dive in much further today, a couple of things that I really want to be clear. The first is that whenever I mention BV, BV is a short term for bacterial vaginosis. And so I might use this back and forth and just know that it is the same infection, the same problem, just different terms. Secondly, males cannot have bacterial vaginosis, as I just mentioned. So I'll refer to that infection in males as urethritis. And that is because the urethra, which is a tube that fluid like urine exits from the bladder in a male to the outside world, it travels through the penis, and that area is where it is most susceptible to having an infection caused by the same bacteria that causes bacterial vaginosis in a female. All right, so now that we have set those terms in order, let's now talk a little bit more about what bacterial vaginosis is. And by the way, I've now talked about this in several videos, including this one linked right here. And so if you are interested in knowing more about treatment, what BV is, and how to help your body recover from bacterial vaginosis, go ahead and check out this video. Now, bacterial vaginosis is caused by a bacteria that normally lives in your vagina. Yes, it's there all the time, every day, young, old, it doesn't matter. It is a part of your vaginal flora, which means the composite of all the bacteria and fungus and different things that lives in the space to protect it, to help us have a normal feeling vagina. The bacteria that often causes bacterial vaginosis is called Gardnerella vaginosis. And so with that, this bacteria lives there but overgrows. So if we're to have 500 of this bacteria living in that space, any number above that causes an infection. Whenever there's overgrowth from this bacteria, you may not have symptoms. And it's important to know that, because so many times patients will have this infection and they're just like, well, I don't feel anything. I couldn't tell. Like, are we sure that there is actually a problem there? And that's because this bacteria will overgrow in the background in the vagina, can slightly change your vaginal discharge to one that is gray, light, thin, but really you may not have noticeable signs. So with that, testing with your doctors is actually probably the most important to actually diagnosing and knowing that you really truly have this infection. Outside of that, one thing that is very common is that you may have an odor that is very different and one that is referred to as being very fishy if you do have the infection. Most people will notice this odor during sexual activity. Outside of that, you may have no clue. But again, check out that video so you can get more details about this. So how contagious is bacterial vaginosis? Well, it can definitely pass from person to person, sexually, with genital contact. And so it's important to understand that for females, our vaginas accept things very, very easily. And so good or bad, It does. And so if there's bacteria on toys that we're using, penises that are being inserted in the space from bacteria from someone's mouth, it can easily cause an infection to the vagina because the vaginas embrace things very easily. So because of how easy it is to transmit things to the vagina, infections are very common in females. Infections in males are much more less likely to happen because males have thicker skin on their genitals, and this thicker skin truly protects them from infections such as that caused by Gardnerella. Now, what's important to know here is that Gardnerella can be on their skin and can be a part of them and can be transmitted from person to person without them actually having an infection caused by this bacteria. So, in other words, this bacteria can live on their skin, can live around the scrotum, around the testes, around their genitals and the skin of their genitals, and not cause them an infection. But in another person, like a female, it may easily cause an infection. Now, the title of our video today is, can you give bacterial vaginosis to a male? The simple answer is no, but in general, males can pick up the bacteria from your vaginal space, keep it on the skin of their genitals, and pass that on to someone else or even back to you. And it's important to understand that because so many times patients will get a treatment for bacterial vaginosis. You've gotten antibiotics, you've completed your treatment altogether and cured the infection, but you'll be reinfected if your male partner still has that bacteria on their skin with or without an infection and you have sexual intercourse again. And so essentially the bacteria can overgrow in your system if this were to occur. But I do want to put a pin here that is very important because as we talk about these infections in the vaginal space, it may seem quite complex and to some degree it kind of is, but know that there's just so many different intricate ways that infections can happen down there. Bacterial Gardnerella vaginitis, the bacteria that causes this infection, lives in the vagina as is. It's a part of that space. When it overgrows, you get an infection. If you get that overgrowth because your male partner is also transmitting and adding to your flora and the amount of that bacteria you have present, you can get that infection. But your male partner does not have bacterial vaginosis, does not have BV, and may not get an infection from the bacteria at all. Now, this bacteria may cause them to have urethritis, which is an inflammation or infection of their urethra. The urethra is the space literally that helps things to exit their body. So it helps semen and sperm to exit the body. It helps urine to exit their body. And so that tube can get inflamed by bacteria that may enter inside of it. And this can actually cause them discomforts and changes that they may notice pretty easily. With that, they may have difficulty urinating, painful urination. They may have like a burning sensation when they're peeing. They may also notice like redness or even a type of like discharge or pus that may come from the tip of the penis when this infection is present. And so it is sometimes really important for them to get treated as well. And this is like an area where in medicine, where it's still kind of like in a gray zone because not every male with this bacteria is having an infection, so they may not need antibiotic treatment. There are times that I absolutely recommend that the male partner be treated as well. This is if, as a female, you typically get these infections. These infections are very recurrent. So you get a treatment, you have sexual intercourse, you get another infection, you get treated, and this cycle kind of continues for a very long time. If you find that you fall in that category, I would definitely have that conversation with your provider to treat or consider treatment of the partner as well, and have that conversation with the partner because they need to be a part of this, right? Sometimes as females, I see that we may keep infections to ourselves and not openly talk about them, but you really want to engage in that conversation with your partner so they understand what's happening in the vaginal area, their potential risks, as well as their potential input and causing this infection. So that together, you can actually work together to make your body better and to decrease the likelihood of having these infections. And so with that, if you are in this recurrent state of having BV and bacterial vaginosis, talk to your partner and explore the idea of them taking the same exact treatment that you're getting to clear any bacteria that's just living on them, whether or not it's causing them symptoms, to see if that overall will settle and decrease the likelihood of you having another infection. And so it's very important that you engage in this conversation, talk about it so that you can get help and plan and take care of your body together. As we continue in the medical world to get more information about these infections, how they pass from person to person and treatments that are necessary, we are still exploring but have found that in uncircumcised men, the likelihood of carrying the bacteria as well as getting infected by that bacteria and passing that bacteria on to others is higher. And so with that, it is just food for thought and to think about what our risk factors are when we're dealing with these infections. And again, that conversation with your male partner is very important in knowing those risks and trying to mitigate them. Many times, the symptoms of infections can be very similar from infection to infection and can make it very difficult for us to determine which exact infection we're experiencing without the aid of a doctor. And so if you are uncertain about what's happening with your body or your partner's, it's important for you to see your doctor, have that conversation, talk about your symptoms, and have them do testing to see what exactly is causing the symptoms that you're having. In that manner, you're not taking treatment that you don't need, but you're also being effective with the treatment that you're getting to clear the problem. As always, I recommend that you also explore the causes of your infection, because so many times we can actually change our habits or our lifestyle or things that we're doing that could be increasing the likelihood of having infections and it not necessarily be the partner that is behind this, but literally the lifestyle that we're living. And so talk to your doctors about that as well. Thank you so much for being here today. I hope that you've learned plenty about bacterial vaginosis and how that can actually be shared from person to person. And so if you have further questions, go ahead, leave a comment below. I love to see them. I love to read them. And so we can help each other as we have conversations that are sometimes a little bit taboo, but not here. This is what we're here for. And so if you have any questions, let us know as well. If you would like to explore this topic a little bit deeper, see these other videos. And I also welcome you to visit my website below where you can get so much more information about this and other important topics when it comes to your female reproductive health. I'm Dr. Perkins, a board certified OBGYN, and I'm so happy that you're here with me and I can't wait to see you next time. Take care.